A letter from almost two dozen activists and community groups fired off to the Magahaga asking for a meeting to address what the groups say is the military's destruction of Chamorro historical and cultural properties. The letter calling for a sit-down with the governor and for her to help push the military to halt construction of the live fire training range and the Marine base site in Finagodzin. Berte Letegzen's Marie Hernandez.
We want to make sure that the military is being held accountable, and our Magahaga is somebody that we feel needs to take that strong stand and fight for preserving what little we have left.
The letter signed by Pertay Letegzen, Independent Guahan, Fuetsen Famalauten, Nacion Chamorro, Hadza Foundation, Nihi, Pagan Watch, the Peace for Okinawa Coalition, and many others. The letter echoes calls from Senators Therese Terlahi and Sabina Perez to Governor Leon Guerrero to push for a pause on construction at the two largest buildup related projects. The military has discovered four new ancient sites on buildup property in the last month. Releases from the Marines call the discoveries significant, and one of those sites has already been cleared, according to State Historic Preservation Officer Linda Uggen. This prompted her to tell the military to leave artifacts in place, and she has not approved a work order for the removal of these latest artifacts.
Anything having to do with our ancestral remains, whether it be lithics or anything, you know, that they left behind as a mark of their settlement there, is significant to us, significant to our history.
Hernandez says although Perte Letegzen endorsed Lou and Josh in the 2018 general election, the group has not sat down with the Magahaga to share their concerns.
Concerns are only getting stronger as more of these sites and artifacts are found. I feel like if we have our Magahaga behind us, that we will be able to make strides that we weren't able to in the past.
The letter reads, in a rush to level our native limestone forests, the military has knowingly destroyed artifacts and natural resources that belong to the people of Guam. It further reads, adverse impacts are avoidable with a halt to construction. Hernandez says the 20-plus groups who signed the letter will attend the meeting if it's granted. She says the governor has a good working relationship with the military, and this could lay the groundwork for a change in the way ancient sites and the artifacts in them are treated.
Have some sort of discussions with the military that might be able to influence how they move forward.
Hernandez says Legislative Resolution 228, which passed with 13 votes in the 34th Guam Legislature, called for a pause on construction on the firing range.
It passed, and yet they still continued with construction, so it's definitely disheartening.
A week ago, KUAM News asked the Leon Guerrero Tenorio administration for comment on the military's discovery of ancient sites and their treatment of artifacts at those sites. We have yet to receive any comment from Adelup. While senators and activist groups are calling for the Magahaga to halt construction, Shipple Uggen, who says she has a meeting with the governor Thursday, tells KUAM News she doesn't think it will be that easy.
And the admiral may not like me saying that, but I was told it cannot be stopped.
For Guam's News Network, Chris Barnett reports.